Hello, welcome to Travel with Sudhi. This is one of America's most iconic, most challenging and memorable hikes. On this hike, you get to walk on some of the best trails, two majestic waterfalls, walk through the forest of giant sequoia trees, and the best part is climbing the final 400 feet on the cables. And the reward is stunning. You get to see the best view of Yosemite National Park. This is Yosemite's most recognizable landmark with 8,500 feet of elevation. Welcome to the one and only Half Dome, Yosemite National Park, California.
I woke up at 4 o'clock to one of the biggest and dangerous hikes in the United States.
You must have the permits in order to climb the Half Dome. You have to apply for the pre-season lottery in the month of March and the result will be announced sometime in April. It is just 1 mile walk from the Curry Village parking lot to the trail hut. You can either take the Yosemite Valley shuttle to stop 16 Happy Isles or just walk. Right after you cross the Happy Isles Bridge, the trail begins with a short right turn following the eastern bank of the Merced River. The trail is flat and easy to begin, but there are some sections with elevation gain. Walking through a forested area with huge boulders to either side is a very picturesque start to your hike. You will pass a sign showing distances of all routes on the High Sierra Loop Trail. Soon, you will reach an area with an amazing view of towering granite formations and dense forest to your right. You can see the Yosemite Falls thundering in the distance from here. At around 1 mile, you will reach Vernal Falls Bridge. This is where you see the first view of thundering Vernal Falls. There is a clean restroom and water filling station here. So if you want to fill your water, this is a chance. Not long after you cross the Vernal Falls Bridge, you will reach the point in which Mist and John Muir Trail splits. If you want to go to top of Nevada Falls without seeing Vernal Falls, take a right, otherwise go straight. At 317 feet tall and against a flat-walled backdrop, Vernal Falls is stunning. You might even catch a rainbow in the spray if conditions are perfect as the waterfall lands in a plunge pool. A little further up, you can actually stand right next to the Vernal Falls drop. This is a fenced off area, but the view is awesome and well worth a quick stop. After around 1 mile from top of Vernal Fall, you will get to see another waterfall called Nevada Fall and then the huge Liberty Gap. From top of Vernal Fall, you will hike about 2 miles through tranquil forest and up more stairs alongside another incredible waterfall called Nevada Fall. The trail split near the top of Nevada Fall. Go left to continue on Half Dome. At this point of hike, there is a restroom, so you can use it if you want. Another 4.5 miles to the top of Half Dome. We have covered only 3.5 miles so far. We have to go another 4.5 miles to the top of After Nevada Fall, the trail levels out a little bit for a mile long at the Little Yosemite Valley, where you can see this beautiful river and tall sequoia trees. It's beautiful. Yosemite is full of wildlife, so sometimes you get to see the wildlife in the early morning. After passing a Little Yosemite Valley, the trail climbs through forest of sequoia trees. Occasionally, you get to see the glimpse of Half Dome, a steady uphill trail taking you to the Sub Dome.
Only 2 miles away from the Half Dome. Thank you.
Now we have reached the subdome. Half dome is just half a mile from here. The subdome is comprised of 100 substairs before you reach the half dome cables. These stairs can be exhausting. I would recommend taking a break once or twice up the subdome to catch your breath, but also to take in the view. The views are spectacular from here.
Wow. Climbing the subdome itself is very difficult. It's very tiring.
From the top of subdome, you get to see the first close-up view of the half dome, and the fun just begins. It is huge. This climb can be very intimidating and challenging. Make sure you are physically and mentally prepared for this hike. The incline is steep and will require you to use your upper body strength to hold on to the cables and pull yourself forward as you climb. This climb is challenging, but the satisfaction and view that you get at the summit makes it all worth it.
Guys, I am at the base of the half dome. The last 400 feet is really, really tough. You have to climb the cables actually, and it is like no 45 degree, like no vertical angle, and it's very dangerous. I did that in 2015, so hopefully I'll do that today, and let's see how it goes. I'm really, really excited.
It took me roughly 25 minutes to climb the last 400 feet cables. Half Dome is an experience like none other. If you have the chance to visit Yosemite National Park and are up for the challenge, do it. You will be able to say that you have completed one of the best hikes in the world. Make sure you take the proper precautions and don't push your limits. While coming down, once at the Nevada Fall, either you can come back to the Yosemite Valley the same way you had come up, or take the different but 1.5 mile longer John Muir Trail. This is little bit less steep than Mist Trail, and the views are amazing. Half Dome hike is a lifetime experience for me, and I will never ever forget it in my life. I hope you all liked my video. If you liked it, please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I will meet you guys in my next video.